So an often used function within the calculator is one variable statistics. We come back to it again and again. And basically what that function does is summary statistics. It takes some data that you put into a list and it tells you all sorts of things about it. So let's take a look. So I put some data into list number one. So if I go to stat and then here to edit, you'll see I have values in my list number one. So in order to get the summary stats, I press stat, I scroll over to calc, and notice it's right there, one variable statistics. That's what number one stands for. So if I press enter, I just need to tell the calculator where the list is. It is list one, but I'll remind you that I would press second and then number one to give the calculator the knowledge that I want list one. Frequency list is really, we only put a value there if we're finding the mean of a frequency distribution, standard deviation of a frequency distribution. So you're not really going to use frequency list very much at all. We move down to calc and then we press calculate. So now we have our summary statistics. Again, this is simply a bunch of data regarding that data set that we put into list one. So the first piece of information you have at the top is X bar. And that is simply the mean of your data set. So it's taken, the calculator's taken all the values, added them together, and then divided by how many data values there are. The second value is a sum. It is the sum of all the data values in your list. The third value there is the calculator has taken every data value in list one, it squares it. Once it's done that to each value, it adds them all together. So that's what the third value is, the 421. Now the fourth and the fifth values are standard deviation. The first value, the S, is standard deviation of a sample. The fifth value is your sigma, and that is standard deviation of a population. The reason you see two values is because the formula for both of those is slightly different, and your calculator does not know whether it's dealing with a sample or a population, because there's no way for you to tell it, yes, this data is from a sample, or yes, this data is from a population. So it gives you both values. You have to be knowledgeable enough to know which one you have so you know which one is right. Typically, we are dealing with samples in statistics, typically. And so typically, you'll be using the S. The sixth value is N. That's simply the number of data values you have. So there's 15 data values in my list one. The next one you can probably guess is min of X. All that means is that your smallest value in the list is one. And if I then scroll down, so notice we can scroll down. After min comes Q1. This is the first quartile. So it's the value in the first quartile. The next value is median. So it's telling you the middle of the data set. What value is in the middle of the data set? The next value is Q3. That's the third quartile. It's telling you the value in the third quartile, which is 7. And the last value is the maximum value in the list, which is 9. There's other ways to find min and max. You can sort your data and pretty easily find what the min and max are. The median, you could also sort the data and find the median by looking for the middle value within the sorted data set. Q1 and Q3 are a bit more work. It's the same as the 25th percentile for Q1 and the 75th percentile for Q3. But as you can see, one variable statistics gives you a bunch of information about your data set, and all you have to do is know how to use it.